For next hands-on, we will try something a little bit different. We will start work with the timers to show you that it's not so completely different, but there are some few minority changes. First of all, the timer is usually very asynchronous periphery. Then we will not use any functions calls like the transmit or receive, but we will use the words like the start or the stop. But first we need to configure our timer. Then we again start with the new project. I will select again the F4, 401, LQFP64 pin package and STM32F401RET. This is okay. Now we use the one of the timers. On the STM32 is usually a lot of the timers. Some have four outputs, usually for the motor controls, some less outputs, some are without outputs. Then I will use very small timer here. In my case, I will use the timer 10. I will activate this timer. This is everything. In case that you want to use the advanced timer, you need here select the clock as the internal, and this will activate the timer. But in my case, I only activate the timer 10. And I will create very simple toggling with the LED now without delay function, because the delay function will be more than less my timer. Then I will here enable again my LED on the PA5 as output. And I will use the timer that after, I don't know, 1 second, I will create interrupt and I will toggle with my pin. I think it will be a very nice example. The clock configuration, I think we can leave the clock configuration in the default, but we need to remember that our timer's frequency is the 60 MHz. This we will use now for the computation. Then now we go to the configuration. We have here our timer 10. Then I will use my timer. And we need to set the parameters. Here in the timers, in the basic settings, we have usually prescaler, counter mode, and the counter period. Prescaler is divider between the counter and the main clocks. Then I will divide this clocks with 1000, but because here the value is a little bit bigger, it's my values plus 1 is the final value. Then if I want to use the 1000, I must put here 999, because in the registers is automatically edit 1, because the prescaler 0 is nothing. Then the prescaler is more than less for the 0 is real 1. Then it will be 9091. And the same for the counter period, because I want to create the interrupt each 1 second. Then I need to put here the 16,000, because my prescaler is 1000, then to the 16 megahertz is 16,000, and because of minus 1, it will be 15,999. No additional clock division, and the counter mode is in this timer only up. Then I will use this configuration. And also in NVIC, I need to enable the interrupt. It's the same like in the previous example. I can also reorder the interrupt priority if I want. But for me, it's now everything, almost everything. I also check here the GPIOs. I have the low, I have the push-pull output. I am fine with this configuration. Then I can store my project. I will call it timer 1. In my case, I will change the folder, and I will generate my project. Okay, we can look inside our project, what is new, what was changed. Definitely, we have here the configuration of a timer 10. We can search for the configuration. Again, we using the handle. We using the instance. We set the instance and we init the basic parameters. And then we call the function HL timer base init, which is the basic part of the timer. Then can be also, for example, the output compare unit, input capture unit. In our case, only the basic input, basic output. Okay, then the timer is configured. We can look into the MSP file. In the MSP file, we enabling only the clocks for the timer. And also we enable the interrupts. Then in the it.c, we can search that we have here also the interrupt handler and the HL handler from our interrupt. Now I think this is the basic. Now we can start the timer because the timer is only initialized. The timer is not running. Don't forget on this. It will be shortcut time, and we need to use the base because we're using only base timer, and we use the start, but we want to start the timer also with the interrupts. Then it's the start underscore IT. And only one parameter is the handle. I put there the handle, then my timer will start. This start in asynchronous, then after I call this function, I immediately leave this function and I can continue in my code. And when we reach the 1 second, we create the interrupt. And now, like before, we need to search for the callback. Then here I go again into the timers and I will search for the underscore week like before. I have the MSP init, MSP the init, output compare, output capture, output compare, MSP init the init, PWM init, PWM the init, input capture init, input capture the init, one pulse mode, MSP init, MSP the init, encoder, MSP init the init. But for me, maybe the period elapsed callback seems like the good try. Then I use the period elapsed callback because this means that I'm on the end of the period. Again, the input parameter of this callback is the handle. Then I can, in case that I have multiple timers, I need to check which time is this, and I here put the HL GPIO and I will toggle with the LED. Put here the toggle pin. The parameter will be GPIOA like before, GPIO pin underscore 5. And I will compile my code. We will see what will happen. Okay, the code is compiled. It's not necessary here to change the optimization, but you can if you want. I will run my code and I will see what is happening. Okay, I'm running my code. You can look on the LED, and in my case, the LED is blinking, and it seems that the the period is 2 seconds, because after 1 second I change the state of the LED, that it seems that in my case is working, and it's also working correctly. But we can say that the create the for the toggling the LED, also the interrupt, it's still some overhead. Then we can use the timer for do more, and we can use the timer to completely handle the LED blinking without any CPU load on the background. We use the PWM functionality in this case for the next hands-on.